is only whisper. No new information. Why are you here?
I wonder sometimes, Gene. Good morning.
Good morning. Superintendent John Ross Null is here. And first of all, a big day for Artesia Athletics yesterday.
It sure was. Yeah, it was a great day. Girls softball and, of course, baseball yesterday had a close one in Santa Teresa fought off to Santa Teresa's run there near the end of the ball game.
Amazing play. I hope, if you were listening, I hope you kind of could gather what had happened from the way Joby was describing it.
Yeah, exciting. I felt I could picture it pretty well, and it sure came at a good time. But proud of all those kids and competing hard and just continuing to battle through the heat and into the summer months, and it's paying off for them with the continued opportunities to keep playing. So yeah. We wish them the best tomorrow.
We do. And then do we have some track? I guess we have some track athletes.
We do have track athletes that are continuing to practice and prepare this week for the state track meet that's coming up this weekend. And I believe my number's right, but that we have about 42 athletes between our girls program and our boys program that are set to compete. I know that that could change a little bit because there's a cap at 16 entrants per event.
Okay.
And so some of those kids may be on the bubble a little bit, but
that's not 16 per school. That's 16
per state. Yes, per event in the state. Yeah, and that may not be exactly right, but it's in the ballpark. But anyway, we've got about 42 kids that are eligible for those spots, and so we're excited for them and for our coaches too.
Yeah. So that I think that's Friday and Saturday. Isn't
correct.
It? Yeah. So it was a good thing that they loosened up to let kids stay overnight, because that just would have been
it would have been a real
strain on resources.
Yeah, it would have
driving
would
up
have.
And down.
Yeah.
So that's good. So we have one more softball game here tomorrow, and then the baseball team is at St. Pius, and then hopefully they'll advance, and we'll have baseball, softball, and track.
Yep, that'd make for a fun weekend.
It'd be in mid June instead of mid May, at least it's it happened.
Yeah, and unbelievably closing in on late June.
I know. What when you talk to other superintendents around the state, what's been their reaction or their thoughts about the efforts that the NMAA did to try to have all sports compete in this year?
Overall, it's been really positive and very supportive of the NMAA's efforts to allow kids to compete in all of those sports, because there was talk as the year progressed and the uncertainty continued even up through February and into March, there was talk of, well, you know what, let's just potentially scrap the winter sports and focus on the spring sports and those kinds of things. But Sally Marcus, under her leadership at the New Mexico Activities Association, and working closely with athletic directors and also superintendents, but primarily the athletic directors, just persevered and things have worked out as well as could be expected given the circumstances.
Absolutely, because it's just been a crazy year. Well, that's good. You want to do kind of maybe a construction update on your different projects?
Well,
going on,
you know, we did
town?
Talk about that some last week, and of course that's continuing and working over at Central and High School, and then our wood shop at Artesia Junior High School is getting a new ventilation so they can have a better place for staining and painting the projects that they're doing. One of the things that we're working toward is in the future, and it's going to take a little bit to get it done, but one of the things we're working toward is more of a construction trades program at the high school. And so our true wood shop program would move to the junior high. So we're trying to just do some improvements there at the junior high to be prepared for that when we can get that done. And a little bit along the lines of construction and maintenance, just want to give a little shout out to our maintenance crew and our custodians, just continuing to work really hard this summer and battle the heat to take care of things and get us ready for next school year. So that's very much appreciated.
Monday's wind and dirt didn't cause any problems,
well,
did it?
We didn't have any major damage, but definitely some tree limbs that had to be cleaned up and some things like that.
Yeah, that was kind of crazy. Yeah.
Another thing that I was going to mention, Gene, is, you know, our students that are in summer school.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a few days left, the rest of this week and 2 days into next week for our elementary students. And then also our secondary students, but specifically our 9th through 12th graders who are working on making up some credits. And then our seniors that are just really working toward graduation and working hard to get that done. Just want to say how proud we are of those students because given the circumstances last school year, you know, kids were in different places in different circumstances. And some of those students that were not able to get the credits that they needed to get for graduation and graduate on time in May, many of them have been right with us through the summer and accomplishing getting those credits this summer. And so we're going to be able to honor those students very soon with a diploma from mm-hmm. Artesia High School. And it's going to mean the same as if they had gotten it in May. And so just want to say how proud we are of those kids for persevering and getting that done and our high school for providing that opportunity.
And a lot of folks, different entities have continued this year with the scholarships. What have you found as far as students transferring to college with all the COVID issues that people were dealing
sure.
with? And it wasn't just unique to New Mexico, obviously. The whole country dealt with it. But
yeah.
does it seem like students from Artesia are able to get their scholarships and be able to get placed in colleges?
You know, I have not had the impression at all, Gene, that it is necessarily limited students' opportunities to gain entry into universities. Universities did ease some of the requirements, specifically regarding some of the testing, SAT, ACT, some of those scores. But as far as scholarship opportunities, as Mr. Parker presented at graduation, the scholarship dollars that our students earned from our community and from universities and other foundations was still a tremendous number, and so I believe those students are set to go and have success at those universities and trade schools and whatever their next steps are.
Well, that's good. That's always important, and you wondered how this would affect things.
Absolutely, yeah.
Part of why you're doing the summer school for some of the younger kids to try to get caught up and get back to where they need to be.
It is, and also we're looking forward, you know, in July, kind of June, you're still kind of wrapping things up from the previous school year, and come the 1st of July, you really start focusing on next school year and what that's going to look like. And as you mentioned earlier in your broadcast, you know, things are trending in the right direction, and we're glad to see that. You know, schedules are coming out as far as athletics and activities for next year, and just really good signs that all that's going to be a go. And so we're looking forward to getting ready for 21-22.
That's good, because a lot of folks, well, you've talked about it before, uncertainty is not a good thing.
It is not a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
It is not a good thing. And we're still waiting for, you know, to work through some of the protocols from the public education department. And in fact, on a superintendent's call yesterday, there was quite a bit of frustration expressed that we have not received that yet. But as soon as we have that information, we'll get that word out and make sure everybody knows what to expect.
Yeah.
And we'll have opportunities to communicate about that.
Yeah, because it's been hinted that they're working on it. And you know they're working on it, but it's been hinted that it's going to come out at some point, and it just it hasn't gotten to the
right.
superintendent's.
Well, so. And what happens is the public education department puts together their recommendations for things, and it goes to a health team, an epidemiology team, and then ultimately, you know, to the governor's office,
mm-hmm.
and we'll see where that leads us. And
yeah.
Certainly, we're our recommendation and our hope is just things as usual.
Yeah, so. get them open up.
Yeah,
absolutely. Because there's been a lot of safety and cleaning protocols that have been put in place. Yeah,
absolutely, year, so. And much of that, those kind of things will remain in place. I mean, we've got HEPA filtration units in all classrooms. We've got the electrostatic foggers that our custodians will continue to use, but certainly we're recommending and hoping that the masks are no longer an issue or a concern, and some of those kind of things are put aside, and we can just move on as normal.
Very good. Anything else?
I'm good, Gene. Appreciate you having me.
All
Enjoyed
right.
the visit.
Hopefully we'll see you Thursday.
I will be around.
And then good luck to everybody, and hopefully we'll get to Saturday.
Absolutely.
So. All right, thanks a lot.
Thanks, Gene. Appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. This is KSVP RT.